Hi, I'm Stavros. Good morning and welcome to Long Haul Commercials here in Tullamore in County Offaly. I'm here to show you all around the brand new Iveco S-Way. So I'll be doing a full tour of the exterior and interior when this truck comes back. Welcome to Long Haul Commercials. The brand new Iveco S-Way from Long Haul Commercials. So it has been very busy today, loads of customers coming in wanting to sit in the truck and test drive it. So this is a pre-production example, so we won't be test driving this particular truck. We'll have to wait until December when Long Haul get in demo trucks and test drive one of them. So this truck will be going on sale more or less in January of 2021, but they are taking orders for the truck. So this is an 11 litre straight six-cylinder diesel engine with 2,150 newton metres of torque. So yeah, they do look quite well. They look even better if they have these silver inserts in the front grille. So they are an option if you want to specify them. That is the key, flicks out. We can unlock and lock our doors, and we can also do a full light test. So LEDs front and rear. So yeah, I've been waiting here for a number of hours just to do my walk around. So yeah, let's continue doing that and checking it out. So yeah, we have the pull out step there. Now when you stand on that, I can just about reach the top of the windscreen. I'm 6'2", so that's pretty good. And let me pull open the grill. I have it unlocked there at either side, just two little levers there. And you can't lock the grill from the inside. So yeah, it would have been nice if it was lockable. So let me just knock off the lights there. I'll show you the rear lights shortly. So the whole cab is on a 4-point air suspended bag system, and we can top up our washer fluid for our oil. And we do have a dipstick, and we also have a engine oil gauge inside in the dashboard as well. So you can monitor it both ways. So yeah, that is your cab tilt, electronic cab tilt. That is a nice feature to have on the S-Way. There we go, back in. So yeah, let me just close the grill again, the step, and down we go on the Iveco. So this is finished in Rosso Metallizzato. That is the color. I'm not great with Italian, but Metallizzato, Rosso. That is the color. So yeah, let's check out the tires. This is a 55 profile super single tire on aluminium wheels, and on the rear we have a 70 profile tire. So of course it all depends what way you specify the truck. You can of course have higher profile tires, but then your rear suspension, the axle ratio may differ. This is on a 2.47 rear axle ratio, and we have a small diameter fifth wheel there, We have four nuts at either side holding on the fifth wheel. Sometimes there's six on any particular truck you may think of, but this is done just to cut down on weight. So the truck would be coming in quite light. That's why we only have one diesel tank. So you have a spare wheel here. You don't usually see tractor units nowadays with spare wheels attached to the unit. But there you have it, and we have our air tank there. So it would have been nice if the air tank was positioned underneath the batteries at the back, and maybe a second diesel tank here. But as I say, it's all done to save weight. And you'll see there on the chassis, we have all the holes there. All done to cut down on the overall weight of the cab. So yeah, we have the full air deflector kit at the rear, and your Suzy layout there. That's tidy. Now we don't have any exhaust outlet for the auxiliary heater. That is positioned underneath the bumper at the front. So that has been changed slightly. So let me just turn on the rear lamps there and give you a look at them. They are, of course, LED as well, and our two wheel shocks and the batteries at the back, as I said. So let me just knock them back off. Now you'll see we have four airbags on the back axle. The front axle is on a single leaf spring setup. You can, of course, get a two leaf spring setup, and you can also get the front axle on an air ride suspension or two steps going up onto the catwalk. We have a 700 litre diesel tank and an 80 litre AdBlue tank. And the catwalk area, quite nicely finished off. And I do like the lip part of it there as well. So that is your air deflector. Now you just push it in to open it up. Some drivers were mentioning that this is a bit sharp when you open it up, but it's designed that way to top up your AdBlue. That's why you open the air deflector that way and step onto your catwalk. This is a left-hand drive example. So you're now looking at the passenger side of the truck. So if I just bend down here slightly, you will see the exhaust outlet for the auxiliary heater, the night heater. Now there's also a cab cooler in this S-Way. So usually some drivers would have a pod on the roof to cool the cab at night, but this has an inbuilt cab cooler, which is very good. So yeah, let's just hop into the driver's seat and see what the interior is all about. Yeah, oh yeah, and one thing I have to point out as well, if I spin quickly around here, they have also carried over the air outlets here as well on the chassis, so that's quite a good feature. So let me just spin right around here because I know you guys want to have a good look at this truck. But yeah, I think they do look very well. So let's just walk around the driver's side and I'll open up that door and we can check out the lockers, because there are quite good lockers on the truck. So let me just open that. We do have three steps going up into the cab, and just unlock that. Now there is no safety catch, which I really like. So if you do have something in one hand, you can open up the locker with the other hand, which is very good. So these are quite a good space. They are quite nice. It would be nice if they were rubber lined, just to stop things sliding around. And then we have the pull latch here, and it opens to the left. But the lockers are an okay size. They're not exactly the biggest, but maybe Iveco have compromised to have this locker slightly bigger. So maybe that has come from driver feedback, have these a bit smaller and these ones a bit bigger. Okay, so it's time to hop inside. The rain is coming down. Okay, let's get the key and slot it into the ignition. And we gotta press the brake pedal. Just a two pedal layout. We do have the ZF Traxxon gearbox, 12 speed automated box. Press the brake pedal and start it up. Now the engine is a bit warm. It's been out on a test drive already. So, couple of revs, 460 horsepower. Okay, let's give the horn a hoot. And Paddy Jennings is holding the door because it is very windy outside and we don't want to damage the hinges. So yeah, one touch up and down for the windows, and we can adjust our mirrors electrically. We can lock the door. Now, some of you will remember the XP570 Iveco Stralis I shot a video on. Now, the mirrors on that had the wide-angle mirror up on the top, but on this S-Way, they've changed them around. So the wide-angle mirror is now at the bottom. So we have the big one up on top. And you'll be delighted to find out that there is now a gap in between the passenger side mirror and the pillar. So you can now look out in between them. No more blind spot there. Now, it would be nice if between the big mirror and wide-angle mirror that we had a gap so that you could look out through it. But there you go. That is the way they have done it on the Iveco S-Way. Now, the windscreen, it would be nice if it was a bit bigger. It is quite narrow, so it's the same as the Stralis. But yeah, I like the push button start and drive, neutral and reverse. But the button layout here is slightly changed. You'll remember that they had a cup holder up here. That's all been moved down here. We do have Apple CarPlay on this example, which is quite nice. Now, had I designed this dashboard, I would have moved the air vents over here, maybe at either side, and moved up the air conditioning controls up here and moved up the handbrake. But yeah, it's pretty much the same layout as before on the Stralis. But these are new, all the cup holder area down here and the drawer there, quite nice. So yeah, the adjustment on the steering wheel, it's just the, as before, it's a button here and you can move it up and down. So it would be nice if it had more reach adjustment and tilt adjustment. So yeah, they need to improve that on the steering adjustment. Anyway, this whole instrument binnacle is identical to the Stralis. The only thing Iveco have changed is within the gauges there, you'll see there is a different design on the speedo and on the rev counter, but everything else is practically exactly the same. And over here as well, all the same type of switches. We have our catwalk light, exterior lights there. And over here we have our anti-slip regulation switch and electronic stability control program. We have the rocking function to get you out of those sticky situations should you find yourself stuck, and our cab tilt button. Now we can go up and down through the gearbox manually, if you wish, through the column stock. Now all the switches on the steering wheel have all been changed on the Stralis. They were all coming down here at either side of the steering wheel, but it's all a different design here. And this particular model has adaptive cruise control. So go down through our functions there. So yeah, it's all quite nicely done, the switches on the steering wheel. Now underneath the steering wheel as well, if I move down here, we have the volume control switch, up and down your volume, and also the mute button. And on the other side, we can change our radio stations. So we can also change the different band radio frequencies as well, FM, AM, and digital audio band. So let's just give it a couple of more revs on the inside. And there you have it, our adaptive cruise control. So yeah, it's quite nice. Now the navigation buttons for going down through the menu, they are at the same side over here. So why didn't they move them over here with the menu function? So yeah, that was a complaint I had with the Stralis, and it's also been carried over to the S-Way. So yeah, I still don't know why they done that, but there you have it. So yeah, you got to press your menu button here and navigate it on your left hand. Okay, so continue walking around. All our air conditioning controls. So over here we have our lane departure warning, and we have our auxiliary heater, night heater. We have a heater there for the fuel, which is quite good. Our PTO switch and our diff lock switch here. Up here we have a battery isolator switch. We can turn off our horn. That is for your rear reversing buzzer. And we also have the cab cooler I was talking to you about earlier, the cab cooler. And you can also preheat the engine system as well. So that's a very nice feature. So this truck is practically set up for cold climates. So yeah, nicely done with the Apple CarPlay. And over here we have our hill hold function, and we can level off our cab with the suspension and our one touch open and close sunroof. So yeah, that's quite nice. So I'm just gonna stand up here and I will tell you that there is about this much over my head of headspace. Now there is still about 3 inches of an engine hump there in the middle. So this is the fridge. I really love this feature. Look, you're sitting in the driver's seat. You just want to take out the bottle out of the fridge. You don't want to open up the whole door. So you can open up this door and reach in and pull out your bottle. So I can see that being copied by other truck manufacturers. So yeah, that's a very nice attention to detail. And the fridge is quite a decent size. Now, on this side, you can get just a pull-out drawer for storage, but this one is a cab cooler. So yeah, you can also put in your normal items there and all your cooling items in your fridge. So yeah, that's very nicely done, isn't it? And yeah, we can also open it halfway if you wish. So the bed, I lay in it earlier, it is quite comfortable. Yeah, that is quite comfy, and we have all the controls on the back wall there, so we can lock and unlock the doors, open and close our windows, volume there, and you can open and close the sunroof and turn on the air conditioning and also your night heater. So yeah, that's quite nice, isn't it? And we can open and close the windows. And over here we have two USBs, and there's also two USBs over here. So depending on what side of the bed you sleep on, so that's quite good. And we can pull down our bunk as well, and also the ladder folds out. So yeah, let me just open that up for you and give you a look. There you go, and we can slide it down there. So yeah, nice touch there. And I really like these little, you see those clips, look? So you clip them in just to hold up your net, and when you unclip them, they spring up, so you're not listening to something rattling. So that's also nice attention to detail. And our two hooks there, and also on the other side. Now, there's no more speaker up here. Two speakers on the door, and your tweeters there on the pillars. So as I showed you before, on the XP, we can restrict this truck to 85 kilometers, and your onboard diagnostic plug and 24 volt socket there as well. Okay, yeah, just a bit of a different design there on this opening here for your fuses. So as I said, this is a pre-production model, so you just have to be careful with stuff that you don't break anything. Yeah, it would be good now to get one of these finally on the road and see what they're like sometime in December. So we have two lockable lockers, just like before. They're quite a good size. The middle one here as well, that's an okay size, and they all have their lamps on them. So there you have it. And we do have ambient lighting as well, so let me just turn on them, and there we go. Yeah, so you'll see there, look, we have a bit of blue there in the ambient lighting. And if I move down to the door card up here, you'll see we have ambient lighting on the door card. So yeah, full leather, and also on the steering wheel. And we have two armrests on both passenger and driver seat. And even the passenger seat here is on air suspended. So yeah, just giving you a full look around. So guys, what do you think of this? Would you have preferred a complete update of the dashboard, or are you happy with this layout? It is a functional piece of design, but of course, trucks are getting more and more modern with bigger screens here and a nice digital screen for your instruments. But this is the Iveco S-Way. Of course, it all falls down to price. What price bracket is this truck? But I can't announce to you yet what is the price bracket. And on the sunroof there, we do have the fly net, and we also have the blockout shade. And if we clip both together, you can have them both on if you wish. So I do like that. And down here we have the shade for the passenger and driver, and the USB connection there, and there's also one here. And would you believe there's two on the fridge? So yeah, 8 USBs in total in the cab. That is pretty impressive. So let's just sit back in the driver's seat, pull down the sun visor, and look, we can extend it here to block out even more sun. So I do like that. So yeah, the Iveco S-Way. What do you guys think of this? Quite nicely done, a nice update. But yeah, it would have been nice to see a total redesign of the dashboard. But yeah, there you go. for an update on the cab. It is pretty nice. But yeah, most of the money I'd say was spent on the exterior, just redesigning that. But still, as I said, a functional piece of design on the S-Way. And there we are, the brand new Iveco S-Way here from Long Haul Commercials in Tullamore in County Offaly. So 460 horsepower from its 11 litre straight six cylinder diesel engine. It develops 2,150 newton metres of torque with maximum power coming at between 1500 and 1900 RPM. Maximum torque comes in at 925 RPM up to 1500 RPM. Just to mention about warranty, there is a 2-year warranty on the S-Way. You can extend it to a third year for an extra €1,200. That's an introductory offer in the Republic of Ireland, so just keep note on that. But quite a nice truck. It's going to look great in company liveries all around Ireland. But yeah, this truck is not going to be in Ireland long. It's spending 2 days in Cork, 2 more days in Enniscorthy in dealerships. So yeah, you got to check it out, because once it's gone in the next couple of weeks, you won't see it at all until December. So get down here to Long Haul Commercials or Enniscorthy or Cork and check out the new Iveco S-Way. So I really enjoyed shooting the video today, learning all about the truck. So I do hope you enjoyed the video. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. And I'll chat to you all again next weekend for another video. Take care, guys. Thanks. Cheers.